हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर जय टंडेल, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इलेक्ट्रिक इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर। दिस इज अ लेक्चर टू ऑफ सब्जेक्ट स्टैटिक वर्क कंट्रोल एंड हार्मोनिक फिल्टर। सब्जेक्ट कोड इज 3720736। द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज इंस्टेंटेनियस पावर थियरी। दैट इज नथिंग बट द बेसिक्स of PQ theory. Many students having a query regarding to how the Clark transformation, inverse Clark transformation is to be formed, why this root 2 by 3, 1 by 2 minus root 3 by 2 will be occurs. So today we are try to clear out the doubt of what is exactly PQ theory, what is applications of PQ theory, how the PQ theory that can be utilized to selection of power converters in the power system. We know that there are various type of harmonic pollutions are there. So this PQ that is deal with some use with some fact devices, so that will be utilized the theory concept of voltage and current with the transformation of ABC to alpha beta, alpha beta to ABC, and so on. So let's start instantaneous power theory, or we can say basics of PQ. So before start, we need to know about what is the actual applications of the PQ theory in a power electronics component. As we discussed in a previous thyristor control reactor and thyristor switch reactors, so they are the compensator. Actually they are use of some anti-parallel connection of thyristor kind of converter, so that having some limits, so PQ theory gives some power real and reactive power, gives some real and reactive power in such a manner we can decide the ratings of the converters. So now start applications of PQ theory to the power converter. So PQ theory is important when the power system is deal with a non-linear load. We know that the power system having a most probably non-linear load. Basically R, L and C are the kind of load in which resistive load, that is linear load, having a VI linear characteristics. But the reactive load that having a L and C that may be in series parallel. So that non-linear characteristics means that when voltage is increased, the current will be decreased, or at not same time, they're having some phase angle. So almost the power system is to be polluted due to the non-linear load, especially on distribution side. So PQ theory used to design of the power electronics devices, especially when that device is used as a power compensator. As I told you, TCR is a power compensator. So in which converter is used, that converter decide by the PQ. So various type of harmonic pollutions in power system, as I listed. First, that is overheating of the transformer and electric motor. Now there is no need to discuss how this transformer is overheated and electric motor is overheated now. But these are the some we know already that. So we are not go into much deep on that this fifth. But these are the harmonic pollutions, right? That is important to understand. So overheating of the capacitor for the power factor correction, we use capacitor connected in parallel to the load to compensate the to improve the power factor, to increase the efficiency. Now we know the distortion, we are not getting a pure sign, right? So that is called as a distortion, that may be notch form, impulse form, whatever. Voltage flickering due to the light intensity, that will be increase. So that is called as a flickering. And fifth one, that is an interference with the communication system. So these are the pollutions. So the PQ theory that define the instantaneous, as I told you, instantaneous value of real and the imaginary power. Actually, we know the apparent power S is equal to P into, S is equal to, we can write v into I conjugate sometime p plus jq. So we have always imaginary term. We already discussed in previous what is reactive power, how it will be affect the power system, how it is important or not. So no need to discuss now. So PQ theory is defined as instantaneous real and reactive power. That's why P, that is a real power, and Q, that is a reactive power of the flexible tools. It is not only for the harmonic compensation but also for the reactive power compensation. Compensation is required, as I told you before. Without compensation, the system current that will be increased gradually, that will be affect badly, we can say. Now, what is actually a PQ theory? So it is based on the set of instantaneous power which is defined in time domain, first of all. So PQ theory, first transform. So power means combination of voltage and current. If it is active form, that is in cos phi, and it in reactive form, then sin phi. So PQ theory is first transfer the voltage V and the current from ABC to alpha beta zero coordinations. Now we will discuss what is ABC form and what is alpha beta form. Generally alpha beta, that is axis, AB, that is a phases, that is with respect to voltage and current. So we can say ABC to alpha beta coordination, that is called, that is lead by the, that is the concept of PQ theory, and is defined the instantaneous power on this coordination. So the PQ theory always considering three phase systems, generally three phase three wire having a zero sequence exceptions, but in three phase four wire zero sequence is that. Now what is sequence? Positive sequence, negative sequence, zero sequence. When it is comes, we know that there is some shifting. So alpha, that is in picture. So alpha in this theory, alpha, that is it is a complex act which is indicate the shifting, like as I told you, 127 phase, that is indicated by alpha. So the three phase now system is unbalanced, so consider unbalanced voltage, that is VA dot, VB dot, VC dot, right? This is the different phases. Now PQ, that is only apply for the three phase system, right? As I consider for the three phase, so we are talking about a three phase now. So now voltage, similar that we are consider the current. So as I told you, PQ convert ABC to alpha beta, so alpha beta, so three phase unbalanced voltage, that is VA dot, VB and VC dot, are transposed into the form of positive sequence voltage, negative sequence voltage and zero sequence. Suppose the positive is indicated by V plus dot, negative V minus dot, and zero sequence is V zero dot. So from that we are obtained some matrix form. So we can say whatever we need to convert, that is here. So we need a sequence voltage. So zero sequence, positive sequence and negative sequence. 1/3, this is considered as a one matrix of A, suppose. So the 1 1 1 1 1 1 alpha, alpha square, alpha square, alpha. What is that alpha? We will discuss later. And which is multiplied with VA, VB, VC. So we can say whatever the conversion of this form, that is the thing of this. So VA, VB, VC, that is of unbalanced voltage, which is multiplied by this sum of the matrix. We know that the upper, that is multiplied with these things. So one is multiplied with VA, one is multiplied VB, one is multiplied with VC, that is a zero sequence, right? Similar, that this is a basic maths. So alpha is a complex number which is at 120 phase shift. As I told you that positive, negative, zero sequence, we are talking about that we have a phase sequence. So 120 phase positively side clockwise and anti-clockwise, that make the positive and negative sequence, but zero, that will be not affected by that. Alpha, that is as I told you, complex number, act as a 120 phase shifting. So we can say 120 e raised to, so that is the reason of we are writing in Clark transformation. The answer is here in the Clark transformation. The two things that you see, one is a root 3/2 form and another is a minus 1/2. So that is nothing but the value of alpha. Now this is the equation 1. If we want to do the inverse, so actually the inverse equations is that suppose this is a matrix A, so inverse of matrix that is some adjoint by MAN, adjoint A divided by MAN A, that is a inverse formula, right? So try to inverse of that. So inverse transformation, so VA, VB, VC, so equation one is similar to that. We need to transfer that. We need to convert that, transfer that. So we need to VA, VB, VC over here, and we try to do the inverse of this A matrix. So the answer is like whatever the horizontal that make vertical, so column that will be converted into row, some form of, and 1/3 that will be cancelled out. So 1 1 1 1 1 1, that is similar. Alpha square is here in previous, so we are doing that inverse of A. Inverse of A, so we are getting this value. So now as I told you, positive sequence, negative sequence, that will be affected by the shifting of 120, but zero sequence that doesn't affect it, so we cannot consider the zero sequence over here, or we can say it is considered as zero. There is no effect during a transformation of zero sequence component. So zero sequence phase contributions, the phase voltage without 120 degrees, so we need to cancel that. So when the positive and negative which is contribute to the voltage in form of the ABC sequence, so we are now, so what will happen in previous, we are consider the unbalanced voltage, we are try to do the ABC to alpha beta, but now we are doing inverse of, because we want VA, VB, VC unbalanced voltage. So that is a voltage, so equation is by inverse of that, so that is called as inverse transformation. Equation one, that is a likewise Clark transformation, but it is not exactly Clark. We will discuss what is Clark. Now the imbalance, the fundamental frequency can be caused by the negative and zero sequence component, because in the balanced system transmission line, only positive sequence components are there. When the fault is occurs or some unbalancing, that negative and zero sequence that is in picture, right? So without that, there is no neutral current which is flow from that. But in case of three phase three wind, there is no neutral, so zero sequence is absent. So negative sequence can be appear in a three phase ground or underground system. So zero sequence component can appear in three phase four wire, because four wire means the fourth of the the fourth of the output side, that is a ground terminal, so zero sequence can maybe flow from. So zero sequence is considered when three phase four line system, that is most important topic, with the ground. Now sum of the instantaneous voltage and current is always equal to zero if the countries consist of positive and negative sequence component. So the reason of always positive and negative sequence components always present in three phase circuit, so when positive and negative present means PQ theory is to be present in three phase three wire system or three phase three four wire system. Now I need to transformation ABC to alpha beta. So first, that is called as a Clark transformation. Now this 1 by root 2 and root 3 by 2, that will be a value of alpha. So now you may be clear. So now instantaneous, as I told you, PQ theory definition wise, it's a instantaneous value of voltage and current considering form of transformation from ABC to alpha beta. So instantaneous voltage in ABC phases, that is considered as a VA, not dot, VB and VC, and instantaneous voltage on alpha beta, that is V alpha, V beta and V zero. So now V zero, V alpha, V beta is equal to root 2 by 3. This is a matrix that you have to keep in mind. 1 by root 2 1 by root 2 1 by root 2, 1 0, minus minus and minus, and that is only the thing is positive, that is over here. Most probably the students are mistake by this, and they are considered a minus over here. Actually there is a plus over here. So and VA, VB, VC, so we need to suppose alpha ABC to alpha beta, we need to we need VA, VB, VC over here, and we need to do the inverse of that. So second step is inversion of Clerk transformation of equation 4, we can say. So as I told, whatever the row, that is make column. So 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2 here in form of n, and so on. 1 by 2 and minus 1 by 2. So 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Similar, the 0, root 3 by 2 and minus root 3 by 2. Now minus, minus, minus and plus is over here. Here is the same thing. Now, similar for the three-phase instantaneous. So this two, that is regarding to the instantaneous voltage. Now similar, that there is an instantaneous current value. So we can say same form, I0, I alpha and I beta. I0, I alpha, same matrix, IA, IB, IC. Now we need to this form, alpha, beta to ABC. We need to convert this ABC over here and it lead to inverse of that. For inverse of that, whatever the row, that is make column. So whatever the row, that is make column. So IA, IB, IC. Now that is a conversion, that is an inverse Clerk transformation, and previous one, that is a simple Clerk transformation. Now alpha beta transformation is the, now as I told you, we are always consider the zero sequence current is zero in case of three phase system. So alpha beta O transformation is to separate the zero sequence component. That is the importance of that. Why we doing a Clerk transformation? Why we doing an inverse Clerk transformation? The reason is alpha beta O transformation is to separate the zero sequence component from the ABC phase component, because we need to cancel this zero sequence. Zero sequence by shifting 180, there is no effect on that. So we need to cancel that in three-phase, three-wire system, not three-phase, four-wire system. And alpha-beta axis then make no contribution. Alpha-beta, that is a alpha axis over here. I have one vectors of that. We will discuss that. So alpha-beta transformation is separate the zero sequence component from the ABC phase component, and alpha-beta axis made no contributions to zero sequence component. So no zero sequence component current is exit. So I0 is equal to zero in this condition, three phase, three wire system. Now if the three phase voltage are balanced, suppose in four wire system, then we can consider three phase, four wire system in which the voltage, three phase voltage of the zero sequence component, that is considered as a zero. So no zero sequence component of voltage present three phase four wire system, but the condition is we have a balanced voltage. So V0 is eliminate from the Clerk transformation. So in a previous one we have this, right? So actually VA is equal to this thing multiply with this. So 1 by root 2 here VO, 1 that is V alpha, 0 that is V beta. But now we know that this thing is need to be 0. So whatever that multiplication, that is 0. So only the term is alpha and beta, that is in picture. Root 3 by root 2 by 3, 1 0 minus 1 by root 2. It is similar. It is from the Clerk transformation. You can see over here, we are considering this thing. We are considering VO, that is 0, which is multiplication of this and this. So we are considering only this form. That is directly I write over here. So V alpha, V beta minus root 2 by 3, root 2 by 3, that is the things. Now further we need to convert alpha beta to ABC. So we are convert VA, VB, VC. So for VA, VB, VC, what we need to do the inverse of that. So the whatever the row, that is make column, row that is make column. Simple equation now. 9. Now graphical representation, that is the meaning of that ABC to alpha beta transformation, that is park. What is exactly happen in alpha beta axis? So consider the alpha axis and the beta axis. So we have ABC, so first A, B and C having equal 120 phase shifting. That's why alpha is considered 180 phase shifting. That's why positive and negative are in picture. So ABC to alpha beta transformation, that is called as Clerk transformation. And inverse class means already we have a alpha beta axis. We are converting that alpha beta to this vector A, B and C. That is called as an inverse class transformation. Now PQ theory. So we need final equation that is in form of power. So power in three phase, we can say it at an instant of time. instant of time. So that's why P three phase, T for time, that is called as a phase A voltage with respect to time, I A with time. So V of T, I A of T plus V B of T, that is for phase A, that is for phase B, and that is for phase C. So V A V T, consider that. So now that is for the, as you know, active power mode, right? But when we are always see the ABC in form to alpha beta, when we are convert transferred to alpha beta, so that power equation that is like that, V alpha I alpha, V beta V zeta, and V zero I zero. But we know that this thing is zero. Okay, lastly, what we are actually doing by converting this. So we have a VA, BC and zero. We are trying to convert that. We are transforming the power actually, right? But we see the next theory, that is a three PQ theory in three phase three wire, in which we understand that only active power that can be moved, but reactive power that is give the magnitude only. So that ABC that is convert into current form and a voltage form. You can see, so VIA, IB, IC, and across that, there is a neutral wire. So three phase instantaneous active power, that is called as, which is actually flow to the load, and here is a load, here is a source, we can say. So now power form, whether we consider zero sequence or not, we have to mention that power in matrix form, that is we have to consider P0, right? We cannot eliminate that. So P0 active power, reactive power is equal to V0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 sequence, V alpha, V beta minus of V alpha. That minus having important. So I0, I alpha and I beta. So in case of three phase three wire, no zero sequence current. So I is equal to zero when we are doing. So now further we are doing some inverse of that and so on. So the real power flow in three phase three wire system in the form of alpha beta component. Right. So now the further equation of power that is in form of vector, that is called as a, we eliminate this. So this. So only we have a matrix that is in form of this form and this form only, as well as this form. We will discuss after, but you have to keep in mind this equation. So this is all this regarding to the basics of PQ theory. Thank you.